Whoa, let's go, guys, let's go. Operation Poison Gift. Welcome, everyone, to Operation Poison Gift. It is yet time to have another wonderful Advent Retaliation missions, where this is just mission number 4 in this run, effectively. We had 2 very difficult first missions, which were sufficiently close, so let's see if this one is a little bit more calm and relaxed. We have an extremely motivated team here with us. You can see a couple of the old all-stars. Baranski here, for instance, with his new look. He's no longer a rookie, he's now a grenadier with this nice little yellow jacket. And yeah, we need to save a couple of civilians and kill all of the aliens, so that's about it. I am positive that we will be able to do that.
You won't have a concealed position for deployment on this one.
Good, here we go. Let's start by getting our range DPS into position. Strelok, we'll move here. And our sniper will move over here. None of these moves triggered, which is good.
I'm on it.
Solid copy.
So we know that there is a sector, and it's currently using high ground. 3 packs overall will exist on this map.
Moving to position. Move out. Go! Get out of here!
Baranski doesn't only save 1 but 2 of them. He's
on your order.
He's efficient, that's for sure. Let's move to here, take the high ground, and engage enemies from there. I'm pretty sure
got it covered.
That we will not engage someone prior to here. The map seems to be pretty open, like very open.
If you say so.
And I'm almost sure that we're not going to approach someone. Both of these guys do have squad size, so we're not going to move them for now. Oh, look at that. Patrol just ran into us.
I've got eyes on Advent troops.
That's an Advent priest. Interesting. They shouldn't be they shouldn't exist in the first month. But yeah, an early Advent priest. They deal a little bit more damage than the normal Advent, and probably they are considered the leader of that pack. Plus, they can heal. How about we start with removing their cover? The reason why I don't want to remove the cover of the Advent priest is the Advent priest will always heal as his first action. That's like hardwired into the AI. So you can abuse it by injuring the others. You can basically waste his first action, so to speak.
On your order.
Ambassador, moving over here. And starting to wreak havoc. Oh, really? You can only see that guy? Well, let me tell you, I highly doubt that. Actually, 74% was too good to just pass. It. Don't want to trigger yet another pack. We can't kill the guy with 4 HP, we can only kill the one with 3 HP, and also only if we're critically hitting or dealing max damage. So might as well just take an overwatch and see what the two guys are doing. We do have a solid cover. All of our guys are in full cover or out of line of sight. He missed.
Taking heavy fire.
Good. B shift. Come on. Really?
It's still moving.
Wow. Okay, first things first, just in case we're fucking this one up. Let's give him a protocol so he has the full cover here. We're not in a time hurry, so there's no need to actually like super hardcore rush anything.
What's over there?
Instead, let's move over there. Very calm, very cautiously. We still got the pistol. Was a crit, but unfortunately not a max damage crit, so only a max damage crit, like maximum damage and a critical strike together, would have killed him. But we do have a chance to take a shot from over here, from full cover, and it's a 50-50. Which we are missing. At least we're now getting context information that we didn't have before. If the guy here is running, we know that there's another pack near. If the guy is staying there, there's just no other pack there. And he decides to stay, so yeah, might as well conclude that there is no other pack here. Okay, B-shift can't take these insults any longer. He's taking his gun. Straight up shot to the neck. Good job, B-shift.
I'm trusting you here.
Rescue? 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 Good. Then just ignore us for now. And we'll try it again. Rescue. It seems that the civilian up there doesn't want to be rescued. Oh yeah, now finally she wanted a rescue.
Back in. Got him covered.
I mentioned the situation, there's like this terror assault, and the XCOM operative says, "Hey lady, how about you just get to the Sky Ranger?" And she's like, "No, that guy over there needs to ask me, elsewise I'm not going to join. Because fuck you." Is there an increased income if you save more civilians? No, there is a bonus if we save 8 or more civilians that we get. We can get a potential recruit, like a rookie. One second, need to get my nose clean again. By the way, it is the HMG. Look at that. We're talking 5-7, so that's not the normal weapon. It's the HMG that he's using.
I'm on it.
Berensky is moving up, and I feel we all agree that it's time for a nice little cover removal. Good job. Good job. isn't this here in line of sight. This here is also not in line of sight. Wow. Good. So effectively, Ambassador here cannot get into line of sight. But he can take an Overwatch, which is just as good.
Check it before you get too close.
That's one down. B shift. We don't want you to really stand there, to be honest. So let's double Overwatch and that's about it. Did the civilian just run through fire and then ignited himself? So I think it's the wrong time during a terror attack to run through fire and finding out that it can actually kill you. I mean, what would he have expected, right? Ah, not good. We need to kill the advent soldier next. The sector next. And why the heck aren't they shooting for the civilians? They should have a higher priority than we do, because they are not in cover. Wow, lucky us that they suck so much. Normally they aren't, but it seems that they are this time. So, let's think about, do we want to use another grenade to deal with these gentlemen? Probably not. But I don't like the aiming odds here, to be honest. If we could go for a grenade, like maximum damage could actually kill the one guy. It will definitely remove the cover. And I would use the flashbang grenade to get rid of the zombie. Yeah, of course it doesn't kill him. Because I think that would be asking too much, like killing him right away. We can now kill the one. The other one with 1 HP will probably survive.
I got it, right?
Unless... unless we are moving up here, which is an option for cover. The sector could go to here to flank us, which is bad. Could go to here, which is also flankable. That's really bad. None of the positions is unflankable. It would be easy to kill the guy down there with the sniper, but I wanted to kill the zombie with a flashbang grenade. So it's now the question, shall we flashbang and just go for a normal standard defensive position, which is probably the better idea. Instead of being greedy and then taking damage. So that will suppress the zombie plus all of his mind spin abilities that could have happened next turn. Let's make sure that our sniper gets the additional cover, and then we're just going for Overwatch. And in case this guy over there is going to move, we can kill him. thought process in this case was what's the most likely way to receive damage. And I think the most likely way would have been that the zombie actually deals damage to us. Good, let's start with the obvious choices here. This guy could die.
Yeah,
oh my god, why, oh why? I just want to kill him, like, he's annoying, he's in the way, and he seems to be dodging whatever we want to do. Taking the pistol, it would be very pleasant to save ammunition, but not for 10% less chance to hit. Yeah, overall, it's not the best move. We're still having four guys running loose there, not a really solid defense. And very soon, that guy here, that sector, will be able to mind control again. Probably will need to take out the sectoids next. These guys are not going to shoot at us as long as there are other targets in the line. And that's, by the way, also the last pick. As soon as we have dealt with them, we should be fine. Good, we have one more grenade to take care of both them.
On the move.
There's one more zombie. Not going to matter this round, but it is going to matter next round. And I specifically think that the mind spin is going to matter next round. So this guy here will also start to have his abilities ready again. But I'm more worried about that sector here. Unfortunately, our grenade didn't remove the cover completely. That's a bummer. On that sector, we don't have another grenade anymore. That's a little bit the problem. He's flanked, so might as well give us. Give ourselves a protocol, try to go for the troopers, and next turn it's sector time.
Target eliminated.
Here we go, 60%. Softening him up. His disorientation is now removed, he'll start to reanimate something. Oh, oh, oh. That's bad news. That's really bad news.
There are rumors about some kind of shapeshifters. I'm guessing this is it.
It is a remarkable species.
If only we had some means of containment.
Don't even think about it.
Well, that wasn't the worst panic ever. Like, moving back and hunkering down. That actually was quite okay. We need to take care about the faceless one this turn. And the sector, probably. There, they keep slaughtering. Wow.
Rock and roll.
All right.
Moving to position.
Berensky, please hit this faceless one. For the love of God. 6 points of damage. That was good. That was very good. Strelok. Five points of damage. That was not super good. Come on. Maximum damage.
Hostile. Terminated.
Good. That was close. He doesn't have a mind spin at the moment, so he'll probably reanimate some shit. He does have a mind spin. And there's the mind spin that I was talking about. Another panic. Hunker down. The zombie will ignore him because he is currently hunkered down. Panicked. Zombies are usually ignoring the panicked units. So if we're lucky, we can get we can kill that. Okay. Well, we need to kill that sectoid over there. So I guess question of the day is, how do we deal with it? And one way how we can do it is, we can go like here, take a shot at the exposed sector. Yes, please. Come on. Good job, man. Ambassador moving into full cover, but yet killing that sector. Very good. That'll take care about also the panic, which is removed for now. And if we're lucky, we can even get the trooper. Well, not 100%, but we got a good shot at him. Oh no, that's... he will take a shot. That was... that was not good. I wasn't aware that the sector could go there. I was pretty sure he wouldn't flank us. Well, so much for our healer. We just lost him. What a damn shame. That was an unfortunate crit and a hit into full cover.
Locked and loaded.
Let's start with him. He's probably having the best chances. 50-50. Good job.
Neutralized.
I think there was yet one more guy down there. We know that the sector is down there. So this here would be a flanking position, even that here would be a flanking position. But if I'm not mistaken, he was down to 4 HP, so a pistol shot might not immediately kill him. Which means, instead, let's overwatch.
Got it covered.
Not good. What the fuck?
They got me flanked. Everything's spinning.
Much closer combat than I would have expected, and it teaches me again that sectoids should be focused earlier in the fight. But then again, the sectoid dealt only a very limited portion of damage, to be precise. The majority of the damage was from, well, half of the damage was dealt by the troopers. And if we wouldn't have killed them earlier, we would be in a very problematic spot.
On the move.
So it's really a double-edged sword. Not a crit.
I guess that'll be okay. Check it before you get too close.
Good, I think we're down to one trooper and that's about it. Pretty sure we are. Let's move into full cover. And let's overwatch in case he's going to move.
Incoming over here. Give it a try. X-ray neutralized.
There's the second faceless one. Too bad we lost the specialist. I would really wanted to use the specialist and level him.
Stepping off. Sure. Moving to position.
So we're not in the danger of being shot, so cover doesn't really matter now.
Let's overwatch.
It's moving all about overwatch. Hitting the target and killing it fast enough. We don't have the most mobile group, so we should kill it in one turn, otherwise we do have an issue. Alright, here we go. It is 76% or a 50-50 with a pistol, so we're taking the sniper rifle even though it could miss.
Menace 1-5, status confirmed. We're not picking up any additional contacts. The AO is clear. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Wow. Close call. I'm not happy with the specialist dying, but I think the rest of the mission was okay. B shift, I never miss. That's a good attitude, man. So, Ambassador unfortunately died here. Very unfortunate. I think zombies should be less HP and more movement. I'll think about it. You raise a very valid point. Ambassador, you'll be missed, man. That was a really good run. Lots and lots of enemy troops.
Hello, Commander.
And I think our specialist training was just the right call. We'll probably even need one more specialist. So for today, guys, it's getting late. As always, I need to go to bed. Work's up for tomorrow. We will see each other on Thursday if you desire to see the next episode of that. And I hope I'll be able to make it on Thursday. Definitely, we will spend a little bit more time on the weekends together. And I'll continue the season 3 there. This seems like a very, very good starting point. If you have enjoyed what you've seen today, hit the follow button and tell maybe at least one friend of yours, hey, Saiken is a cool guy, you should give him a try. XCOM 2 is such a lovely game to watch. That would make me happy. Yeah, and in this sense, have a nice evening, everyone. Enjoy your Tuesday and stay frosty. Until next time. Bye-bye.